In this video, I'm going to show you 7 mobile editing tricks for Beaver Builder, and I guarantee you might know some of them, but you definitely don't know all of them. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on that subscribe button. If you don't want to miss a thing, click on the bell. YouTube will let you know when I have a new video. We're going to be in Beaver Builder today, and more specifically, Beaver Builder 2.1, which ironically was just released today. So I've already gone ahead and pulled this up, and I'm going to try to go through these 7 mobile editing tricks a little on the faster side. So let's see if I'm able to actually pull that one off. Okay, number 1 is when mobile editing, you can actually stay in the mobile editor if you don't click save. Let me show you this. So on anything in Beaver Builder, when you click on it, we get our option box. We can click on advanced, and then right where it says margins, you get this little monitor. But if you click that twice, it puts it into mobile editing mode. And so I can scroll down here and I can start editing things just to be mobile specific. I can start editing a variety of things, and those are what we're going to talk about in this video. But here's the key. So right now I'm working on this heading, but I can go ahead and click right here and I can make some mobile specific adjustments to this heading. But the minute I click on save, it's going to kick me out of that mobile editing experience. So the first step is don't click save until you're actually done. So to get back into mobile editing, we just need to find one of our options like margins. Click it twice. It'll kick us into the mobile editor. Do not click save until you are done. This is actually something I'm asking them to fix to keep it in there. All right. So that was number 1. Number 2, you can have visibility based upon device type. And this is one I'm sure some of you guys already know about. So a perfect example is I can go into the row settings right here, click on the little wrench, go to advanced. And when I scroll down, there is this option right here where it says responsive layout. I can choose if I don't want this shown on a mobile device, and you have a variety of options here. So that is tip number 2. Tip number 3 is mobile spacing, and that's where it's really going to come in handy, staying in this mobile editor. For just about every module in here that you can use in Beaver Builder, there's going to be a margins option, and there may also be a padding option. So when I click right here into this heading right there, I click into advanced, we have margins for that. But then if I click into the row setting by clicking on this wrench and clicking on advanced, we have margin and we have padding options. So right here, any value I put in here is going to be specific to a mobile device only. Okay, so that was number 3. Number 4 is mobile alignment. A lot of things will have specific alignment for mobile devices. So here is a heading. I'll go ahead and click in it. I'll click in style and I'll scroll down, and we have our normal structure. But as I scroll a little bit more, we have our mobile structure. And here's an option right there for alignment. And if I wanted it to be right aligned, or if it's normally right aligned, but in the mobile device, I'd prefer for it to be centered, I can have that option right here. You just choose custom, and then here's for custom alignment. You can choose whatever you want. And the same thing goes to number 5. Now, the 5 is the last basic one. Okay, number 5, we also have custom font sizes for mobile devices. So if you see this mobile structure right here, I can change the font size. I can change it from default to custom, and I can go ahead and put a different value in here. If I wanted to make it smaller, say maybe 20, I can just go ahead and enter my 20, and you're going to see it change size. And there it is. Okay, so now that we've gone through this, let's go through some of the more advanced options. Let me get out of here. I'm going to click save, and there we are back to here. So number 6 is a little harder to explain. It's called reverse stacking order. So the way any mobile responsive page is going to work, when this switches into mobile view, they start stacking this on top of this on top of this, or this column on top of this column on top of this column. So remember, we have girl, plant, table. So if I go into the mobile preview layout right here and I scroll down, let me scroll down here, we have girl, we have plant, we have table. You can easily reverse this stacking order if you chose to. Now, the times you're usually going to want to do that is when you have alternating content. So when you have one row where there's maybe a picture and some text, and underneath it you have some text and then a picture, you wouldn't want that same stacking order on a mobile device. This is how you reverse stacking order. It's pretty simple. You would go ahead right here and you would go into your column settings. You would go and hover over this element, and right here where it says edit column, there's this option here called column settings. Something real funny about column settings, I didn't even know this was an option until a year after using Beaver Builder. There's actually column settings. Anyways, we go into the column setting, click on advanced, and we scroll down. There's an option right here that says stacking order. So I can reverse this if I wanted to, and then click on save. So now, remember we had girl, plant, table. Now when I go into the mobile preview, we should have table, plant, girl. I'm going to go to preview layout, click on a mobile device, scroll down, table, plant, girl. There we have it. That's reversing your stacking order. Now, some of you guys might have known about all of these, but there might be one thing that you didn't know about, and this is mobile column widths. I think this might be a little newer of a feature. I actually didn't realize this was there until kind of fairly recently. So we would do that same thing where we would go ahead and get into the column settings. So I'll go here, and now I'm back into my column settings. So right here, normal on a desktop, the width is 33 1/3. So what you see is this takes up a third of the full width, this takes up a third, this takes up a third, and it's spread out that way. But then when you go into mobile responsive mode, it just stacks. This column takes up 100%, this takes up 100%, and this takes up 100%. Not in every layout does that make sense. You might want to have two columns side by side on a mobile layout. I'm going to show you how to do that. Okay, so here I am in the column settings just for this column. I'm going to click on advanced. I'm going to scroll down, and we have these options right here. Responsive layout. There we go. Small device width. Now, by default, a column will go and take up 100% of the width, but I can change this to custom, and I can go ahead and change it from 100% to 50%. So I just entered 50. We're not going to see anything right here. And then I'm going to change this one to 50 as well. So I'm going to go to column settings, advanced. I'm going to scroll down to small device width, change it to custom, and I'm going to put 50 in there, and then click on save. So now what we saw before was this on top of this on top of this. Let's see what happens now. I'm going to go to preview layout. I'm going to click on a mobile device, and I'm going to scroll down, and there we have it. Now they're side by side. You see how this opens up some additional options. It's great when you're showing different images. There's just so many great uses for having the ability to control the column width on a smaller device. It makes so much sense. I think by default, the way that a page becomes mobile responsive, it just makes it so there's a lot of scrolling you have to do, and there's a lot of wasted space. I gotta say, out of this list of seven, my very favorite feature is this mobile column width. So there you have it, seven mobile editing tricks for Beaver Builder. I'm sure you knew of some of them, but you definitely did not know about all of them. Hey, if you are interested and don't have Beaver Builder, I have a link in the video description box, or you can visit WPCrafter.com/Beaver Builder. That will actually take you to a page that I have where I give you some information about a course I have on Beaver Builder version 2.1 that I like to give away to people when they purchase Beaver Builder through the link on that website. This course has been made for Beaver Builder 2.1. It covers the basics of choosing your styles for your website, building it with Beaver Builder. There's also an advanced module on Beaver Themer. It's the most complete course available for Beaver Builder. All that information's right there. So, hey, did I leave out any of these mobile editing tricks for Beaver Builder? I'm pretty sure I might have left one or two out. If you would go ahead and fill in the blanks in the video comment section down below and let me know what I might have missed missed out on. And if there was one of those that you didn't know about it that I already listed in the video, I'd like to hear about that too down below. Hey, thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.